To deliver a lecture on probability. The theory of probability, as a matter of fact, is a study of random and unpredictable experiment and is useful in investigating of important feature of these random experiment. If a random experiment repeated under essentially homogeneous and similar conditions, we generally come across two types of situations. The result, or what is usually known as outcome, is certain or unique. And second, the result is not unique, but may be one of the possible several outcomes. The phenomena covered by one is known as deterministic or predictable phenomena. And by deterministic phenomena or predictable phenomena, we mean one in which result can be predicted with certainty. For example, the potential difference E between two ends of the conductor and the resistance R are known. Then the current flowing in the current conductor is uniquely determined by Ohm's law, which is I equal to E by R. The second example is, if we know distance between two destinations and time covered to that destination, then we can uniquely determine the velocity of the object which covered this distance. There are phenomena as covered by second, which do not lend themselves to deterministic approach, are known as unpredictable or probabilistic phenomena. For example, in tossing a coin, one is not sure if a head and a tail will be obtained. A salesman cannot predict with certainty about the sales target next year. Now, basic terminology. In this section, we shall explain and define various terms which are used in definition of probability under the different approaches. Random experiment are those experiment whose results depending on chance. The word random may be taken as equivalent to depending on chance. For example, tossing two coins simultaneously, then there are four possible events and the sample space are head-head, tail-head, head-tail and tail-tail. And the now, the second definition is sample space. Set of all possible outcomes of a random experiment is called sample space or universal set, and it is denoted by capital S. An element in sample space is called sample point, and therefore each outcome of a random experiment corresponds to a sample point. Next definition, trial and event. Consider an experiment which though repeated under essentially identical conditions and the results are not unique but may be one of the possible several outcomes. Then such experiment known as trial and the outcomes are known as event or cases. For example, throwing a die is a trial and getting head or tail, getting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or 6 as an event. Tossing a coin in a trial and getting head or tail is an event. Next example, drawing of two cards from a pack of well-shuffled 52 cards is a trial and getting a king or queen is an event. Exhaustive events. The total number of possible outcomes in any trial is known as exhaustive event or exhaustive cases. For example, tossing a coin, there are two exhaustive cases which are head and tail. The possibility of coin standing on the edge being ignored. In throwing of a die, there are six exhaustive cases since any one of six faces 1, 2, 6, 2, 2, 3, 2, 6 may come uppermost. Next example, in drawing of two cards, from a pack of 52 cards, the exhaustive number of cases is 52C. In sense, two cards can be drawn out of 52 cards in 52C2.
ways.
Next, favorable event or cases. The number of cases favorable to event in a trial is number of outcomes which entail the happening of the events. For example, drawing a card from a pack of 52 cards, the number of favorable cases to drawing an ace is 4. For drawing a spade, card is 13. Drawing a red card is 26. In throwing of two dice, the number of cases favorable to getting the sum 9 is 3, 6, 4, 5, 5, 4, 6, 3, and there are 4 favorable cases to getting the sum as 9. The next definition, which is most important in probability theory, mutually exclusive or mutually disjoint events. Events are said to be mutually disjoint or mutually exclusive if the happening of an event precludes happening or the other events, that is, no two or more of them can happen simultaneously at the same time. For example, in throwing a die, all six pegs numbered 1 to 6 are mutually exclusive. Since any one of these pegs come, the possibility of other in the same trial is ruled out. Similarly, tossing a coin, the event, head and tail are mutually exclusive. Next one is equally likely events. Outcome of a trial is said to be equally likely if taking into consideration of all relevant evidence, there is no reason to expect one in preference of others. For example, tossing an unbiased or uniform coin, head or tail are equally likely. In throwing an unbiased die, all six pairs are equally likely to come. The next one is independent or dependent events. Several events are said to be independent if the happening or non-happening of an event is not affected by the supplementary knowledge concerning the occurrence of any number of remaining events. For example, in tossing an unbiased coin, the events of getting a head in the first toss is independent of getting a head in the second, third and subsequent throws. If the probability a card from a pack of well-shuffled card and replace it before drawing the second card, the result of the second row is independent of the first row. But however, if the first card drawn is not replaced, then the second row is dependent on the first row, and such events known as dependent event. Mathematical or classical probability. The James Bernoulli first obtained the measure of uncertainty and known as classical probability. He defined it if experiment or trial results in n exhaustive, mutually exclusive and equally likely cases or outcomes, and m of them are favorable to happening or occurring of an event E, then probability of P. That means probability of happening of event E is given by ratio of number of favorable cases and total number of exhaustive cases, and in this case given by M by N. We compute the probability in above formula by logical reasoning without conducting any experiment. Since the probability in 1.1 can be computed prior to obtaining any experimental data, it is also called or termed as priori or a mathematical probability. Example related to classical definition. What is the chance that a leap year selected at random will contain 53 Sundays? In a leap year, which consists of 366 days, there are 52 complete Sundays and 2 days over. The following are the possible combinations of these 2 over days: Sunday, Monday, Monday and Tuesday, Tuesday and Thursday, Tuesday and Wednesday, Wednesday and Thursday, Thursday and Friday, Friday and Saturday, and Saturday and Sunday. in order a leap year is selected at random should contain 53 days, one of these two over days must be Sunday. Since out of seven possibilities, there are favorable only first and seventh to this event. Therefore, required probability, which means favorable cases upon exhaustive number of cases, is 2/7. The second question related to classical probability. A letter of English alphabet is chosen at random. Calculate the probability that a letter so chosen is a bohai. In this case, the sample space consists 26 letters of English alphabet. Therefore, number of exhaustive cases in this case is 26. And event E, the letter chosen is a bohai. That means favorable event consists 5 letters A, E, I, O, and U. Therefore, number of favorable cases is 5, total number of exhaustive cases 26, and therefore probability of first case is 5/26. In second case, precedes M, N is a bohai. Letter chosen is precedes M, N is a bohai. In this case, number of favorable cases is only A, E, and I, not O and U, because they follow the M. So number of favorable cases in this case is 3 out of 26 cases, and therefore required probability in this case is 3/26. Some remarks related to classical definition of probability. Since n is always greater than or equal to 0, which shows number of favorable cases in any trial, and n is always greater than 0, not equal to 0. And it is clear that n number of favorable cases is always less than or equal to total number of exhaustive cases. Therefore, probability of any event not less than or equal to 0, that is probability of E greater than or equal to 0, and probability of E not more than 1, which means probability of E always less than or equal to 1. And this implies that probability lies between 0 and 1 only. Sometimes we express the classical definition by saying that odds in favor of event E are in ratio of favorable number of cases and non-favorable number of cases, that is M and N minus M. And the odds in against of event E are shown by in ratio of non-favorable cases and favorable cases, that is N minus M is to M. Since the number of cases favorable to non-happening of an event E are N minus M, the probability Q that E will not happen is given by number of favorable cases to non-happening of event E is N minus M divided by total number of exhaustive cases N, and therefore is equal to 1 minus n by n, where m by n it shows the probability of happening that event, and therefore 1 minus p. So q equal to 1 minus p, therefore probability of happening and non-happening of any event is equal to 1. Next one is an important formula to solving any classical definition related probability questions. The probability of happening at least one of the event E1, E2, E3 to EN is equal to 1 minus probability of none of the events E1, E2, E3 or EN happens. Next remark is related to probability of event in different manner. In probability of P happening of an event, also known as probability of success, and the probability Q of non-happening of the event as the probability of failure. If for any event the probability is equal to 1, then such event known as certain event, and if probability is equal to 0 of any event, then such events known as impossible events. Now, there are some limitations of classical definitions. this definition of classical probability break down in the following cases, in which first case is if the various outcomes of trials are not equally likely. For example, the probability that a candidate will pass a certain exam is not 50%, since two possibilities, possible outcomes, which is success and failure, excluding the probability of compartment, are not equally likely. If the exhaustive number of cases in a trial is infinite or not known is a second limitation of classical definition. For example, selecting or even number less than 10 out of n natural numbers. In this case, number of exhaustive cases are infinite and we cannot find probability by this method. So, because of limitations of classical definition, a new definition of probability generated statistical or empirical or estimated probability, which is defined by one who says, if a trial is repeated a number of times under the essentially homogeneous and identical conditions, then the limiting value of the ratio, the number of times the event happens, to number of trials, as the number of trials become independently large, is called the probability of happening of the event. It is assumed that the limit is finite and unique. Symbolically, if n trials and event E happens n times, then the probability P of happening of event E is given by limiting value as n tends to infinity of m by n. For example, if we want to find the probability that a spare part produced by a machine is defective, study the record of defective item produced by the machine over a considerable period of times. If out of 10,000 items produced, 500 are defective, it is assumed that the probability of defective item is 0.05. Remark related to empirical definition. Since the relative frequency approach, the probability object obtained by objectively by repetitive empirical observation, and so it is also known as empirical definition or empirical probability. Empirical probability approaches to classical probability as number of trials becomes indefinitely large. In next section, we find study limitation of empirical probability. If an experiment is repeated a large number of times, the experimental condition may not attain remain identical and homogeneous. The limit in 1.2 may not attain a unique value, however large n may be. Next one is the important in probability theory, old derivation and all the proof directly or indirectly solved by axiomatic approach of the probability. The axiomatic definition of probability include both classical and statistical definition as particular case and overcomes the deficiency of each of them. On the basis, it is possible to construct a logical structure of the modern theory of probability. This modern theory of probability introduced probability simply as a number associated with each event. It based on certain axioms which express the rule for operating with such numbers. So, definition of axiomatic probability: let S be a sample space of a random experiment. If to each event A of sample spaces we associate a number PA, then PA is called probability of event A. If the following axioms are hold, the first axiom is for every event A, probability of event A is always greater than 0 and known as axioms of non-negativity. The second axiom, for sure event S, probability of S is equal to 1 and known as axioms of certainty. exemptor for any finite or countably infinite number of mutually exclusive events A1, A2, A3 and so on of a sample space S, that is probability of union of such events is equal to sum of their individual probabilities. And this axiom is known as axiom of additivity. Some theorems on the probability. In development of probability theory, all the results are derived directly or indirectly using axioms of the probability. In this section, we shall prove some simple theorems which help us to evaluate the probability of complicated events. The first theorem is the probability of impossible event is represented by pi, or sample point represented by pi is equal to 0. The certain event s and impossible event phi are mutually disjoint events. That is s union pi equal to s. Therefore, probability of s union pi is equal to probability of s. Now, by axioms of additivity, probability of s union pi is equal to probability of s plus probability of pi because of s and pi are mutually disjoint event. And by axiomatic definition, probability of s union pi is equal to probability of s plus probability of pi. And so, probability of pi equal to 0 because of probability of s cancel out by right hand side value, and probability of pi becomes 0. And this proves that probability of impossible event is always equal to 0. If a year selected at random, one example related to impossible event, if a year selected at random, find the probability that February 30 is a Saturday. The given event can never occur as no year contains a day which February 30, hence required probability is 0. Similarly, we can prove that the probability of complementary event A bar of A. We can represent complementary event by A bar, not A, A dash, A in superscript of C, A C, and is given by probability of complementary event of event A is 1 minus probability of A in similar way as in previous theorem. Because of A event A and the complementary event are mutually disjoint event, and therefore A union complement of A equal to sample space. And therefore probability of A union A bar is equal to probability of S by third axiom of axiomatic definition of probability. This is axiom of additivity. Probability of A union A bar is equal to probability of A plus probability of A bar, and probability of S equal to 1. Therefore, probability of complementary event is equal to 1 minus probability of A. The next and important theorem of the probability, addition theorem of the probability. If event A and B are, if A and B are two events and are not mutually exclusive, then probability of happening A or B is equal to probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A and B. In mathematical notation or in set theory notation, probability of A union B is equal to probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A intersection B. So events are not mutually disjoint, therefore their common part given by this reason, and this part shows in red color is A union B. We split this A union B into three parts in which only A or A intersection B bar or only B, only A node containing B. And we can write this event as A intersection B bar is equal to A minus A intersection. If we subtract this part of the common part into A, we get A intersection B bar. And probability of A intersection B bar is equal to probability of A minus probability of A intersection B. The second division is A intersection B. And third part is A bar intersection B, only elements of B not containing A. And we can represent it by B minus A intersection B. That means only B, not A. And probability of A intersection B bar is equal to probability of A minus probability of, sorry, probability of B minus probability of A intersection B. So we can represent event A union B into three mutually disjoint events, A intersection not B, union A intersection B, union not A intersection B. So probability of A union B is probability of union of these three events. If these three events are mutually disjoint events, therefore by third axioms of additivity, probability of A intersection B bar plus probability of A intersection B plus probability of A bar intersection B or not A intersection B. By the previous calculation, probability of A intersection not B is equal to probability of A minus probability of A intersection B. Probability of A intersection B as it is, and probability of not A intersection B is equal to probability of B minus probability of A and B. And after simplifying, we get probability of union of two events is equal to probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A intersection B when events are not mutually disjoint. If events are mutually disjoint, then their occurrence of simultaneously is equal to 0, that is probability of A intersection B is equal to 0, and in that case probability of A union B is equal to probability of A plus probability of B. For example, if we select a card from a bench shuffle 52 car, pack of 52 cards, and that card is either spade or king or diamond card or heart card or club card, then these events are mutually disjoint events, and therefore the probability of either spade card or diamond card or heart card or club card is probability of spade card plus probability of diamond card plus probability of heart card or plus probability of club card. That is, there are 13 cards of each suit, and 13 by 52 plus 13 by 52 plus 13 by 52 plus 13 by 52, that is 1. Or a card is selected at random, and that card is either king or queen or jack or S card. So these four events are mutually disjoint, there is no common event between them. So probability of happening is S or king or queen or jack are probability of some of their individual probability, that is 4 by 52, 4 by 52, 4 by 52 and 4 by 52. Summing all these values is equal to 16 by 52. Now, the second case in which events are mutually disjoint. Probability of a card is selected at random, and that card is either king card or spade card. In this case, events are not mutually disjoint because there are one card which is both king card or spade card. So probability of king card और स्पेड कार्ड इज इक्वल टू प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ किंग कार्ड प्लस प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ स्पेड कार्ड माइनस प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ किंग कार्ड एंड स्पेड कार्ड. सो प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ किंग कार्ड, देयर आर फोर किंग एंड आउट ऑफ वन कार्ड इज सिलेक्टेड इन 4C1 में एंड वन कार्ड सेलेक्टेड आउट ऑफ 52 कार्ड इन 52C1. सिमिलरली फॉर सेकंड में प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ स्पेड कार्ड, देयर आर 13 स्पेड कार्ड्स एंड वी सेलेक्टेड वन इन 13C1 में एंड टोटल नंबर ऑफ एग्जिस्टिंग प्लेसेस इन दिस केस 52C1 माइनस प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ किंग एंड स्पेड कार्ड. ओनली वन वेरिएबल केसेस आउट ऑफ 52 कार्ड्स, सो 1/52 इज प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ किंग एंड स्पेड कार्ड. आफ्टर सिंपलीफिकेशन 4/52 13/52 माइनस 1/52 इज इक्वल टू 16/52. देयरफॉर प्रोबेबिलिटी दैट अ कार्ड इज सेलेक्टेड एट रैंडम इज आइदर किंग और स्पेड कार्ड इज 16/52. बिकॉज ऑफ इवेंट्स आर नॉट म्यूचुअली डिसजॉइंट वी अप्लाई एडिशन थ्योरम ऑफ प्रोबेबिलिटी. That's all for today. The next